Welcome to Teller's for English. Let's go live to Caracas, where the Supreme Court of Justice is offering some statements. Let's see.
The Supreme Court of Justice will proceed to read a communique. The Supreme Court of Justice of the Bolivarian Republic of Venezuela, on behalf of the judiciary power, repudiates once more the interfering U.S. actions of in the internal affairs of the Republic by imposing coercive unilateral measures, illegitimate, illegal measures on 16 official Venezuelan officials, among them the justices Carislia Beatriz Rodriguez Rodriguez, Fanny Beatriz Marquez Cordero, Inocencio Antonio Figueroa, María Kia Gil Rodríguez, and Juan Carlos Hidalgo Pandares. Likewise, the judge Miguel Cisnero, such a recurring practice against our homeland and Venezuelan officials are violating the principles of the international rights, which as self-determination and democracy, in the Venezuelan constitutional system is being exercised by the people. In such regard, we reaffirm the content of the Constitution preamble that expresses the people of Venezuela exercising their creative powers, invoking the God's protection and Bolivar's example, and our indigenous and founders of a free sovereign homeland to establish a democratic society, participatory protagonist democracy, a state of justice that consolidates the values of freedom, independence, peace, solidarity, the welfare, the integrity of the territory, coexistence, and the compliance of the law for these and future generations. Likewise, as daughters and sons of Simón Bolívar, we are not going to surrender, to kneel down before foreign forces. That's why this Supreme Court of Justice has been promoter of peace in Venezuela, and our decisions has been centered in the judicial and national order to impose justice before any hurdles. Venezuela and the representatives of all public powers has been facing the challenge, the historical challenges of external aggressions that we have been dealing with during the last decades, with the aim of weakening the Venezuelan institutionality in an attempt to tear down democracy and hinder the good course of the Venezuelan state, which can be described as a new colonialist action that still is in the conventional systems of conventional methodologies of some international systems. So I quote Bolívar's, the United States of America seem to be destined by Providence to spread misery all over Latin America on behalf of freedom. Likewise, the judicial power expresses its solidarity with the rest of public powers, which has been attacked and discredited by the U.S. imperialism. We ratified our commitment to peace, sovereignty, and the independence of our beloved Venezuela, Caracas, on September 13, 2024. That is all. Thank you very much.
We were listening to the president of the Supreme Court of Justice of Venezuela expressing the body's rejection of U.S. interference and U.S. newly imposed sanctions on the country. So, as we were saying, we were listening to Caricia Rodriguez, president of the Supreme Court of Justice of Venezuela, as she expressed on her behalf, on the behalf of the body, the rejection to the U.S. sanctions imposed on the country. We will come back with more updates in upcoming news brief. Stay tuned with Closer English.